Inhale with Steve Ross.
Okay, stand up, wake up. Time to do some yoga. Welcome to Inhale, step the feet wide apart. Slide the hands down the back of the legs and go all the way forward. Grab the heels or ankles if you can and pull down a little bit. If that's too extreme to start with, then just hang down, that's okay. You can bend the knees if you need to. Keep the neck relaxed, breathe through the nose no matter what happens. Just gonna hang here, let it all open up. Bring the hands down. From here, turn the left foot all the way out. Sorry. Turn the right foot in a little bit to face it. And just walk yourself over. Hang down over the straight left leg. If you can walk your hands out a little bit, that's okay. You want both legs straight, both feet flat. If it's too intense to bring the hands to the floor, you can bring them up on the shin. Ankle if necessary. Relax your neck, keep the breath moving. Rather than coming up, just slowly spin on the heels. Walk yourself over to the other side if you can. Same thing. If you want a little more intensification here, you can pull the right hip back, push the left hip forward. I just came to see sure the next day is relaxed. Okay, turn the feet straight. Roll all the way up. Keep the feet fairly wide. You may have to bring them a little bit closer. Bend the knees, squat down. You can bring the forearms on the knees or thighs, or if you're very flexible, you can bring them down to the floor like that. If you don't feel anything, you can always step the feet wider apart. If it hurts your knees, you can turn the feet out a little bit. That's fine. This is an excellent preparation for camping. Or any trips to any third world countries you may be going to. And bring the hands down, straighten the legs, but continue to hang down otherwise. Bend the knees, we'll do it one more time. This time slightly different. This time the arms come straight out in front of you, kind of push the butt back behind you, flatten the back as much as possible. You can add flying sound effects if you want. Hopefully you haven't eaten beans in the last 24 hours. Bring the hands to the floor, straighten the legs. slowly roll all the way up. We're ready to rock, even if you're not. We're gonna do it. Step the feet together. I love this song. From here, bring the hands in prayer pose. The usual prayer is, please don't hurt me. Then inhale the arms up. Drop the head back. Exhale, come all the way forward. Hands down to the floor, flat down if you can. If this is too much, bend the knees. That's okay. Step back or jump back into the top of a push-up. Just stay here. Hands are right underneath the shoulders. If this becomes too difficult at some point, you can always bring the knees down. Very slowly, try to keep the elbows close to the ribs as you sink down. The palms are flat down, fingers spread wide apart. Once you get there, inhale and arch up into the upward facing dog. Legs are straight, tops of the feet are on the floor, arms are straight. Push the chest forward. You can drop the head back to stay here for a few breaths. You can always kind of slide the hips up closer to the hands. And then push back into the downward facing dog. Tuck the toes under. You can walk the feet in a little bit toward the hands if you want to. Same thing here. The hands are flat down. Fingers are spread wide apart so you get a strong base with the hands. Try to sink the heels down. Legs are straight. Back is flat. Neck is soft and relaxed. Just breathe deep through the nose. Hang out here. From here, light as you can, step or jump the feet up to the hands. And roll all the way up, stretch up, arch back. Exhale, come all the way forward. Hands down, head up, jump back or step back. Come down slow. Inhale, arch up. Exhale and push back, down dog. From here, raise the right leg up in the air. Push the left heel down. You can roll the hip open. If you want a little more stretch in the calf of the standing leg, though, you can keep the hips level. It's a different way to work it. Try to keep the arms straight. And swing the foot up to the hand into a crescent pose. Straighten the back leg, stay on the ball of the back foot. We're not gonna stay here too long, just a little bit. And that's a little bit enough. Come down with the hands, step the foot back. Sink down slow, or not. Inhale and arch up into the up dog. Exhale, push back into the down dog. Raise the left leg up in the air. Push the heel down, right heel down. And swing the foot up into a crescent. We'll be right back and we'll do the other side. And we're back and we're on this side of the crescent pose. Left foot should be forward. Right leg is straight. Arms are straight.
Well, I tell you what.
Grooving to Heavy D
I've
and BB King.
To do this. Is that right? I never thought that I'd get a chance to, well, try to do some rapping.
And true to the other side, that's enough. Bring the hands down.
I need your help, man.
Step the foot back. Come down. Arch up, up dog. Laced with hip-hop, it's heavy. And push back into the downward dog. Walk the feet in a little. Again, sink the heels down, arms straight, back flat. Breathe.
Blend with the friend, make you shake your ass. You can ask for a lot, but don't ask for no cash.
Keep it calm. Right, yeah. Check me out. I love this song, too. Keep it calm. I love these songs. From here, jump the feet up to the hands. You're not going to love this, though. Chair pose. Arms up in the air. You look like you've done this before. Arms straight. Bend the legs. Sink down.
For real. I can set you straight. Pluck your strings like they never been plucked. Strum you to sleep. So tell me what's up. I like how you shine. Would you be mine? State your case over my place.
So take that's a good line. Bring the hands down. Straighten the legs. Lift the head. Lift the head up. And jump back, or step back, come down slow, or not, and arch up, up dog, push back into the down dog.
Get my own guitar, turn her into a star, right? And I'm out. Peace.
Jump the feet up to the hands, sit down, and turn around. You're going to bring the hands down on the floor with the fingers spread.
Just leave it on in there.
Like that, about a foot behind you. Push the feet flat if you can. Push the hips up, chest up, and come all the way into the reverse slant pose. If this is too intense, then let the feet come up so you're just on the heels. That's fine. We're going
to
hold it for the rest of the show.
Lucille didn't know she'd never do any rapping at all. But you know, she
and then sit down, spin around.
Right.
Cross the legs, bring the hands down in front of the bent knees. You can either step the feet back or jump them back. Once you're there, be careful. Arch up. I like surprises. Push back, down dog. Even though you don't. Right leg up in the air. Swing the foot up. Come into a crescent pose. Straighten the back leg. Turn the back foot, the left foot flat down. Turn to the side into a warrior pose. Keep the right leg bent at a right angle a little bit. Slide the foot back a little bit for that. From here, bring the right hand down, flat down to the inside of the foot, left arm straight up in the air.
Well, she sounds pretty good to me.
From here, if you can, reach underneath the front leg with the right arm. Grab the left hand or wrist or fingers behind your back, rolling the left shoulder open. If that's not going to happen, then just keep the right hand on the floor and drop the left arm behind you. But keep rolling the left ribs open no matter what you're doing. Back foot is flat. And bring the hands down to the floor and step the foot back. Come down, arch up, up dog, and push back, downward dog. Keep the breath moving all the time. Left leg up in the air.
Keep it calm.
And swing the foot up into a crescent pose first. Again, turn the back foot flat down, turn to the side. Warrior pose. Try, if you can, to bend the left leg down so the top of the left thigh is pretty much level to the floor. You want the left knee directly over the left ankle, or more or less. Bring the left hand to the floor, right arm straight up in the air. Keep trying to roll the chest open.
All you wanna do is ride around, Sally.
Ride, Sally, ride.
Sing it. All you wanna do is ride. Reach underneath if you can, grab the right hand while singing the background vocals.
All you wanna do.
And bring the hands down. Step the foot back. Come down. Arch up, up dog. And push back, down dog. Jump both feet up to the hands if you can, or step them up if you can't. Roll all the way up, stretch up.
Arch back a little if you want to.
Exhale, come all the way forward. Hands down, head up, jump back or step back. Come all the way down. Arch up. And push back, down dog. Right leg up in the air. Swing it up. Crescent pose. To say it, but lean out over the front leg. Come on up into a balance pose. Arms in front of you or behind you.
I'm gonna be wiping those weeping eyes. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Bring the hands to the floor and the leg up in the air. And bring the foot down to the floor, hands on the floor. We'll be right back. We're going to do the other side. You're watching Oxygen Media.
I know you want to leave me, but I
really. And we're back, and we're doing the other side. So this time, lift the head up, jump back or step back. Come down, slow and easy. Inhale, arch up. And exhale, push back, down dog. Left leg up in the air this time. Swing the foot up into a crescent pose. Back leg is straight still, front leg is bent. Do the best you can. If you have to bend the back leg a little, that's all right. Try to keep the arms straight. Slowly come on out into the balance. Again, arms are either in front of you or behind you. Bring the hands down. And and the leg up. Splits as best you can. Keep the leg straight. And bring the foot down so the feet are together. Bring the arms up in the air. Bend the legs. Chair pose. The easy chair. The way some of you are doing it, lounge chair. Okay, hands down. Straighten the legs. Lift the head up. Hang in there. Jump back or step back. Don't come down yet. Stay up in the top of the push-up. Very slowly, geological time. It takes millions of years to move even a half an inch.
Book of Revelation, chapter 7, verses 6.
And then inhale and arch up. Yes, into the up dog.
Neither shall they thirst anymore. Preach, preach up, for God shall wipe away. Yes,
and exhale, push back down.
Get ready for the revolution.
We're grooving now. Right leg up in the air. Now they're going for it. Swing the foot up. Turn the back foot flat down. Bring the forearms, if you can, down to the floor, to the inside of the front leg, like that. Or you can reach underneath the right leg and grab the right ankle from the outside, like that, but it doesn't matter. Either one of those, just keep the back foot flat down. If this is easy for you, you can tuck your head under the leg like she's doing, Michelle's doing. But generally, you need to get a fire hose to get her out of that one. Try to keep the back foot flat down. And bring the hands to the floor, step the foot back. Come down. And push up, up dog. And push back into the downward dog. Let's have a revolution. Left leg up in the air.
You know Jesus is the true son, the second in the Trinity. I know you're feeling him. 500 days left into the new millennium. You hear
it? Swing it up. Turn the right foot flat. Other side. Bring the forearms, if you can, to the floor. That's okay. Or you can reach underneath if you like. Again, if you want to tuck the head, you're crazy, but go ahead. The arms are there kind of like a safety net. Most of the weight is still on your leg if you're lucky. And bring the hands down. Step it back. Come down. And arch up, upward dog. And push back into the downward facing dog. Stay here, breathe. Opening up the upper back and shoulders. Not to mention the back of the legs. Jump the feet up to the hands. Roll all the way up, stretch up, arch back a little bit. And exhale, come all the way forward. Step the feet apart a little bit. Actually, step them fairly wide. So we're gonna do something I don't do that often. You'll know why as soon as we try it. turn the right foot out about 45 degrees, not all the way. Then bend the right leg, sink down like this.
The left heel is down, the toes are up, ideally. Don't lean back. You want to kind of lean forward into it. If you don't feel anything, then something's wrong with you. But if you need to feel more for some reason, you can always turn this foot down like that. Here comes the good part. Right over to the other side you go. That's not really the good part, but it's getting better. You can always push the knee back like that with the elbow. Okay, now this is the good part. With no hands, you go back and forth. You can make, you know, hula dances, or you can do, exotic stuff, or you can be like this. It's perfect with this music. Go fast, go slow, but do something. Then when you get to the middle next time, plant the hands down, straighten the legs, and hang forward. You can, if you want, grab the big toes and pull down, or grab the heels and pull down, or just hang there, that's okay. Keep the legs straight if possible. If you're pulling down, you can try to bring the head towards the floor in between the feet, so you might bring it back a little bit. Say what? Slowly roll all the way up. We'll do one more pose. This is a standing pose. It hurts, so if this is too much for you, don't worry about it. Grab the inside of the left foot or ankle. Right arm comes straight up in the air. Lean forward. Kick the back foot back. Do the best you can. Go slow. Really kick the back leg back. That'll make you lose your balance and you'll have to fall. All right, come down. Shall we try the other side? Yes. Grab a hold. Come into it. Go slow. Pretty good. Close enough. Come down and hang forward. We'll be right back. Stay tuned to Inhale. And we're back. So here's what we're going to do. The bridge. Slide the feet up, bend the knees, in other words. Feet are flat on the floor, about hip distance apart. Very slowly push the hips up in the air, kind of tucking the pelvis under as you go. So you're lengthening the low back, low spine. Once you're there, you can interlock the hands on the floor underneath you, or you can have them flat on the floor, or if you're extremely lazy or tired, you can bring the hands underneath the hips or waist to supported variation. Now, if you feel like you want a little bit more, and don't everybody do this, turn the hands backwards over the shoulders and push up into the wheel pose. Arms are very straight. Try to walk the hands and feet closer together if you can. Really push down hard with the feet. Keep the breath moving. Okay, come on down nice and easy. Pull the knees into the chest. Okay, one more time. The bridge or the wheel. Whichever one you like, do the other one. Come on up. As you get more and more flexible in the back, you can probably get the hands and feet a little closer together if you're going for the wheel. But the idea is not so much to get contortion-like in your practice, but really just to feel it open up your body so your body gets nice and open, nice and relaxed, nice and loose, nice and happy. Sleepy. And come down. Again, pull the knees in. Sometimes two is enough, but not today. Last one. In the words of that famous guru-ess, Jacqueline Suzanne, once is not enough. Come on up, way high. See if you can relax your neck, which I doubt if you're going for this. Breathe, though, really use the breath and really push down hard with the feet so the legs are very animated, working. Oh, we're back at the beach. A nice place to do yoga. If you like sand in your mouth. So come down slowly. Last time, pull the knees into the chest. Straighten the legs on the floor. Flip over on your stomach. Just relax for a second. That's long enough. Push back into the child's pose. Just relax here. This helps counter-stretch the low back a little bit. Take some deep breaths. If you breathe into your stomach, it kind of indirectly massages your low back, which indirectly feels good. And then sit up. Turn around. Sit between the feet and lie back as far as you can. If you can bring the knees together, that's nice. If that's too intense, don't do that. If it's not intense enough and there's maybe a couple in here that's so for. Then you can pull one knee in toward the chest, keeping the other knee on the floor. But generally, you need a lot of surgery to get to this. Have your bones removed and garden hose put in instead. So just stay here. Feel the stretch in your knees, ankles, thighs, low back. If your low back is on the floor, you're in severe trouble. Generally, there's a nice arch. Lumbar curve should be there. So if the back is off the floor, that's good. If it's too much on your knees or ankles to even sit between the feet, just sit on the feet. That's okay. If it becomes uncomfortable, that's not unusual. But if it's really too uncomfortable, come out for a minute, move around a little bit, and then go back into it. Or just come out of it, go get something to eat. And then just watch the rest. That's nice. And then come up into a sitting position. Turn around. Bring the left leg straight out in front of you. The right leg you bend, you want to bring the sole of the right foot to the inside of the left thigh on the floor. Or if that's not enough and you feel exotic, you can pull it up into a half lotus. That's okay also. In any case, inhale the arms up. Exhale out, extend out as you come down. Try to grab the foot. If you can't grab the foot, grab the shin. Grab someone else's foot. But stay here, we're gonna be here for a little bit. Just let the breath move. Slow and deep. Long exhales in particular slows the mind down because the breath and the mind are so intimately connected. One never goes anywhere without the other. So if you slow the breath down, the mind also slows down. When the mind slows down, then you become patient and you can just hang out here for a long time with no problem. If your mind is racing like yours is, it becomes more problematic. Every now and then, if you need to shift around a little bit to get comfortable, that's okay. But you want to try to keep pushing the back of the knee down and extending the heel. And when you hold it for any length of time, you also want to drop the chin down toward the chest. And slowly come on up. Let's do the other side. Pull the left leg in. Same thing, inhale the arms up. Exhale out. Finish this off when we come back. Stay tuned to Oxygen Media. If you're doing anything else, forget it. It's time to lie down. So, once you're on your back, just let go. Move the shoulders away from the ears so there's a sense of space in the neck. Take a very long, slow, deep breath all the way to the top of the lungs. Hold it for a moment or two. And let it go. One more time. Long, deep breath. Just let it fill you up. Hold it. And release it slowly. and just bring your attention to your body, the tactile sensation of it on the floor. If you look at your body with your mind's eye, you won't be able to tell where it stops and the space that surrounds it begins. In other words, there's no sharp defining edges to it. It's just a sense of open, boundless space. See if you can intuit that or cultivate that sense. So rather than identifying as just a cage of bones and flesh, you're the awareness that's inclusive of everything. It includes the entire universe, according to the yogis. The entire universe is your body. Take a long, slow breath. Start to bring your awareness back a little bit to the world of the senses. Except keep the eyes closed. Very slowly roll to one side. Take your time. Leisurely would be good. From here, float yourself up into a sitting position, facing the front, eyes remain closed gently. Palms are up on your knees or lap. Just sit for a moment. Going by present evidence, with your eyes closed, can you even tell if you have a form, much less what it is? You know, as children, you play, you're an airplane, you're a car, you're a boat. Why? Because they're a little closer to reality. They know that their form is not what they think it is, somewhere. So in this moment, can you tell if you have a form at all? Only by present evidence. The only thing you really know for sure is that you exist. Everything else is a belief. I am, this much you know. So bring the palms together into prayer pose. Namaste.